What if analysis? How to decide the campaign budget? How do we use data tables in Microsoft Excel and run a what if analysis to decide what will be the optimum budget to run a marketing campaign, a promotional offer for our customers? And you can use this for any business. So in this example, we need to run a promotional offer for a cricket team merchandise, so printed t-shirts for cricket team fans. So we'll decide what will be the campaign budget that will help us earn a profit that we want from this campaign. So what are the assumptions for this campaign? First, there's a fixed cost of INR, Indian rupees, 45,000 for the company to run the campaign, the resource cost and everything else. Cost per unit. So this is what the company has to spend to either manufacture or procure every t-shirt, that is 129 Indian rupees, and there'll be a cost of 49 rupees as shipping charges for every order. And the company intends to start with a selling price of 499 Indian rupees. And the cost per lead when they run a marketing campaign, so whichever channel they would be using, whether it's Facebook or it's Google, the cost per lead historically has been 11 rupees. These are the assumptions. 45,000 fixed cost, cost per unit is 129 plus 49. Selling price is 499, and there's a cost per lead of 11 rupees. So the question is, how much should we spend on a 30-day campaign to ensure that the campaign is profitable? And if the goal is to make a profit of 100,000 Indian rupees. So let's use data tables in Microsoft Excel to run a what if analysis and answer this question for this company. So let's get started with the what if analysis using data table for the t-shirt promotional campaign. So here are the assumptions that we have for this campaign. So the selling price is 499 rupees. That's what the company wants to sell every t-shirt for. The fixed cost during the campaign, including manpower, resources, and everything, is going to be 45,000. The variable cost, so the cost price, what it costs the company to procure or manufacture every t-shirt per unit is 129. And there'll be a shipping cost of 49 rupees per t-shirt. Cost per lead is 11. This is based on analysis on the camp platform that they'll be using and also some historical data. So they want to start with a campaign budget of 100,000 and they expect a conversion percentage of 4%. This again is based on historical data, or you could also get some estimates using different online tools. So now they need to understand that if they run this campaign, this promotional campaign for t-shirts for a cricket team, would this be a profitable campaign? Would they be able to make enough profit to justify running this promotional campaign and spending on marketing? So here, if you look at right now at a 100,000 campaign budget and a 4% conversion at this selling price, cost price, and they would be making a loss of 28,273. So what will be the optimum campaign budget at a 4% conversion, or at a slight range, like say 3%, 5%, what would be the optimum campaign budget? And would it even make sense? So one way to do is that you manually keep changing numbers. Let's say I want to spend 200,000, for example. At 4% conversion, I would still be making a loss of 11,545. So what is an ideal number? What if I spend 250,000? So at 250,000, I'll still be making a loss of 3,182. What if my conversion percentage is 5%? Then I'll make a profit of 69,773. But as you can see, this is cumbersome, trying every permutation combination. And that's where a data table comes into picture. So this is what a data table looks like. So on the horizontal axis, we'll have the marketing campaign budget. On the vertical axis, we'll have the conversion percentage. This first cell is a reference cell. This tells the data table where the formula for calculating profit comes from. And in our sheet, the cell that contains the formula profit is C18. So C18 becomes the reference cell for the data table. And here we need to now pick a range. So let's say the marketing campaign budget, the minimum budget that the company could think of is 100,000. And they'll keep on increasing this by another 50,000. So the range would be from 100,000 to 500,000. The conversion percentage, the minimum that they've seen has been 3%. Let's start with 3% and let's increase this by 1%. So 3%, 4, 5, 6, and 7. This is the combination that the company would like to try, that if they spend anything between 100,000 to 500,000 and the conversion is between 3 to 7%, what would be the sweet spot for them to run the campaign? So now what you need to do is you need to select the entire table from the reference cell till the end of the table, and you go to data, what if analysis, you select data table. It'll ask you for a row input cell. So the row input cell is the cell that has the marketing campaign budget. So that is C11. The column input cell is the cell that has the conversion percentage. That is C12. And then all you need to do is click on OK, and the calculation will be done by Excel. So if you see right now here, the cells with the red font are where the company would be making a loss. So let's say if the company spends 250,000 at a conversion percentage of 3%, they'll be making a loss of 76,000. At 4% conversion, it'll be 3,182 loss. At 5% conversion, they'll be making a profit of 69,773. So now they have the entire picture there in form of a table, and they could decide whether they should go ahead with the campaign. Now, in case if 4% has been a realistic conversion percentage for them, even if they spend 500,000, they'll be making a profit of only 38,636. Let's say the company for this month wants to make a minimum profit of 100,000. And only if they can make a profit of 100,000 will it make sense for them to go ahead and run this campaign. So let's do a small conditional formatting here. Let's go to home. Let's go to conditional formatting. Highlight sales greater than 100,000. That's the revenue goal. And fill it with green fill. Okay. So now you know that these are the cells where they'll be making a profit of 100,000 and more. This is close to 100,000. But the minimum that they would need to spend is 200,000 if the conversion percentage was 6%. But that is way more than what they've expected and achieved historically. So at a 5% conversion, which is more realistic, they need to be spending 350,000 as a campaign budget. So now they can take a more informed decision. What if they say that, okay, let's do one thing. Let's maybe, instead of selling every t-shirt at $4.99, let's go ahead and sell every t-shirt at $5.99. Then, even at a 4% conversion, at a spend of 300,000, they could make a profit of 114,273. This seems more realistic. So what this table does is it gives you the entire range, the permutation combination, which would be cumbersome doing manually. And now the entire management can review the table and decide whether they want to go ahead and run the campaign or not, and whether they want to change the unit dynamics. So, is there a way that they do not increase the selling price or increase it marginally, let's say 549, and they reduce this cost by another 10 rupees, and maybe they negotiate on the shipping cost and make it 39? Even then, if you could see at a 4% conversion, they could still make a profit by spending 350,000 rupees. So now it becomes very easy to play with the numbers and see the entire outcome and take an informed decision of whether they should go ahead with this campaign or not. So this what if analysis can be done for a variety of business scenarios, and we will discuss more. But in case if you have any particular scenario in mind where you think you would like to use this, you comment below. And also, this sheet that I'm using right now as a demo is available as a free download. The link is in the video description. Go ahead, download it, and try using it for your own campaign. If you need customization help, again, comment below. And similarly, Excel has a lot of other use cases. Here's another very useful Excel template that I have made. There's a subscription tracker Excel template. You could go ahead and watch the video that's there in the on the screen right now. go ahead, watch the demo and see if you like it. If it's useful for you, go ahead and download this as well. So I'll see you in the next video. Take care and be safe.